Checking.
Hello. Are we live? We're live.
We're live.
Welcome to Good Friday Worship Night. This is certainly, you know, we had planned on doing worship night on Good Friday several months ago. Just got tuning the orchestra back. But obviously that looks a little different, as all of our lives do in this season right now. But and initially, I think in my mind a couple weeks ago, it was just like, we won't do anything. We'll just let everybody stay at home, be with their family. But then I felt really impressed that we should do this tonight, no matter what it looked like, no matter, you know, how many people, hopefully a lot of people tune in. But our Jesus is incredible, and he made an incredible sacrifice for us. That's what this day represents. And so we just want to gather together and sing him some praises. So if you're driving in your car, if you're in your living room, wherever you're at, let's just think about tonight. I really want us to center our minds on the cross. And some of your days might have been hectic. Really, my day was pretty wild up until this point too. So I know that I'm really looking forward to this time, and just to think about what Jesus did for me. And that's what's awesome, is he did it for the entire world, but it's a very personal thing. He did it for each individual that's watching this right now. So y'all worship with us as we sing.
Wait, we're in the key of F.
Yeah.
from Luke 23. It depicts when Jesus was hanging on the cross. When they came to a place called the Skull, they nailed him to the cross, and the criminals were also crucified, one on his right and one on his left. Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they are doing." And the soldiers gambled for his clothes by throwing dice. The crowd watched, and the leaders scoffed. "He saved others," they said. "Let him save himself if he really is God's Messiah, the Chosen One." The soldiers mocked him too by offering him a drink of sour wine. They called out to him, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself." A sign was fastened above him with these words, "This is the King of the Jews." One of the criminals hanging beside him scoffed, "So you're the Messiah, are you? Prove it by saving yourself and us too while you're at it."
But the other criminal protested, "Don't you fear God even when you've been sentenced to die? We deserve to die for our crimes, but this man hasn't done anything wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." And Jesus replied, "I assure you, today you will be with me in paradise." By this time, it was about noon, and darkness fell across the whole land until 3 o'clock. The light from the sun was gone, and suddenly the curtain in the sanctuary of the temple was torn down the middle. Then Jesus shouted, "Father, I entrust my spirit into your hands." And with those words, he breathed his last. When the Roman officer overseeing the execution saw what had happened, he worshiped God and said, "Truly, this man was innocent."
Father, I pray, make me more alive.
think my heart was worth the pain. Joy, could you see beyond grave? Love found my soul worth dying. Savior, the promise of the empty tomb. And when I think think about the scripture we just read when he said it is finished. That means that he took every bit of our sin. On top of all the torture that he went through, on top of all the suffering that he did, that means that he had taken it all. And the song we're going to sing just talks about the sin that he carried for us and the sin that he took for us. I'm just thankful that I can live in grace, I can live in hope because he took that upon himself. The sin of my past, the sin of my future, the blood of Jesus just covered it all. Let's sing this. Faith was nothing on the providence I know. Oh,
Thank you.
your love continually not only fights for us, but also guides us. And I pray that not only today, but especially on Easter Sunday, that we're able to rejoice in the midst of everything going on in the world. That it doesn't matter if a pandemic is going on. It doesn't matter if natural disasters are happening. Our hope and our foundation is in you and you alone. And I pray that we constantly and continually trust you and seek your will in our lives. In your name I pray. Amen.